everybody, the Sunday Morning Superstars, Bob Holly and Aldo Montoya in the ring. And I tell you something, I think that woman came to save Leonard Hirsch Helmsley. There's got to be some kind of relationship, at least that's what in my mind, between the Bionic Woman, this Amazon, and Helmsley.
I think she's a German native. As a matter of fact, I understand her name is Gladys Murphy Nugent. She should have been here. She's a German native. Now, I don't know who she is. I don't know what's going on. But I think she's either stalking Marlena or stalking Helmsley and doesn't want anybody else to get a hold of him.
One thing's for sure, we know that at WrestleMania, it will be Stone Cold Steve Austin and Bret Hart in a submission matchup. And neither man has ever given up in their entire career. Plus, Mr. Helmsley, what has been a most personal rivalry with Goldust, Helmsley and Goldust to go one-on-one. I'm sure we'll hear more about that tomorrow night on Raw. And maybe we'll find out tomorrow night on Raw Is War from Worcester more about this mysterious Amazon. But right now, we've got tag team action. The team of Doug Furniss and Philip LaFond against Aldo Montoya and Bob Holly. We are in Berlin. And, of course, the Furniss and LaFond have a great international reputation, James Z, after competing in the All Japan Wrestling Organization for several years as regular tag team partners.
I think it's been almost 7 years since Furniss and LaFond first teamed up. So they've got the experience advantage here over Holly and Montoya. But I think you're going to see a lot of good wrestling, which the people here in Germany, frankly, appreciate. Wow!
LaFond misses the spinning heel kick, and Bob Holly with a good shoulder block. Bob Holly, the two-sports star here in the WWF with a nice shoulder block. I wonder if your good friend Paul E. Dangerously is going to show up tomorrow night on Raw.
Oh, I hope he does, because I hope that Jerry the King Lawler takes his fist and drills Paulie's teeth down his throat so far he'll have to clear customs to come back. That's what I hope. I'd love to see that lying punk get knocked out.
Hey,
of course,
on.
That's just my opinion.
I thought you and he had a lot in common, but that's another story.
No, he beat me on everything. He was the first one to lose his hair before the age of 30 and the first one for his waist to reach 40.
That's the strength here by Doug Furniss, former University of Tennessee football star and powerlifting champion. Grew up in Mickey Mantle's hometown of Commerce, Oklahoma, did Doug Furniss. And the pace quickens here. And Furniss with great athleticism. And a high hip lock. Tremendous hip lock. And an arm drag. We've got some great tag team action. And folks, we'll be right back. Please stay with us. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen, for tag team action. Bob Holly. Oh, LaFond just hit steel.
Holy mackerel.
LaFond just smacked the steel. And, boy, this could be a big moment in this matchup. A momentum breaker, to say the least.
That was a bad mistake. Watch, he tries to catch Holly with the shoulder. He caught the post and head first to the floor. And Phil LaFond may have made a very bad error that could cost Furniss and LaFond the match.
Bob Holly now focusing on that arm. Furniss and LaFond will be involved at WrestleMania along with the Headbangers, the New Blackjacks, and the Godwins in a four-team elimination tag match. And it's a high-stakes matchup in as much as that the winner of that four-team elimination tag at WrestleMania will earn a WWF tag team title matchup.
And, of course, the tag team title will be decided when the British Bulldog and Owen Hart defend against Vader and Mankind at WrestleMania.
Tag has been made to Aldo Montoya, who continues to focus on that injured arm of Philip LaFond here. Good strategy by Aldo and by Holly, who are certainly meshing well here. We're not seeing too much inconsistencies. They've got some continuity.
Holly is a tremendous competitor. So is Montoya. And they're showing that they're thinking as well, because they're going after the injured body part from when LaFond hit that steel post.
Holly taking a chance now. He's up on top.
Oh! Wow! Where are his teeth? I think the better part of them are stuck in Phil LaFond's boot sole.
Bob Holly took a chance. And sometimes that's what happens when you take a chance. It certainly doesn't pay off, and it has given LaFond the opportunity to tag in the powerhouse, Doug Furniss.
Furniss is showing that, wow, that form that he had at the University of Tennessee.
There's a cover, one, two and a half.
A football star with that tackle.
Furniss now with a power slam with authority. That could be all, and Bob Holly showing a lot of determination. He's not going to stay down long. There's a backslide. Pinning combination again, but again, we have only a near fall.
These guys are going after it. Each one trying to put the other away and put him away quick. Jockeying for position.
Inside cradle, good counter, beautiful counter at two and a half.
Holly was able to kick his legs and reverse the momentum, came right down in that jackknife.
And LaFond, wow. LaFond with Excellent counter. And you can tell the intensity is certainly at a high level here. Well, I'll tell you what, we saw that live event promo, some great live events just around the corner. Tonight in Springfield, Massachusetts. Tomorrow in Worcester at the Centrum, as we talked about.
Look at Aldo! He didn't even bother stepping in the ring. He came off the top and all the way across the ring.
Aldo's face just met the ring post, or the ring rope, I should say. And there's a cover. One, two, three. No. Not three.
Unbelievable.
Aldo may have dimmed his lights here. Let's take another look.
Watch it. He catches his face across that top strand of rope, and I think it knocked him half out. Wait a minute. LeBron would go over. Yes. Holly drop kicks Furnace out of the way and sends LeBron over in the sunset flip. This is too quick to call.
LeBron and Aldo, the legal men in a matchup. And Aldo fight for all his worth here.
Got trapped.
LeBron, and that suplex off.